Today is Tuesday, April 30th. This is the Transportation Committee. I'm the Chairman of Transportation, Tim Kennedy. We are joined by the Ranking Member of Transportation, Joe Robach, along with our colleagues, Senator Galvin, Senator Benjamin, Senator Jacobs, Senator Kaminsky, Senator Kaplan, Senator Persaud, and last but certainly not least, Senator Skoufis. We're going to.
Thrilled to be here.
We are going to get right to it. Again, we have many bills on the agenda today, and we're looking forward to moving them right along. So, with that, we will get started.
First bill, Senate 289 by Senator Ort, an act relating to authorizing the Village of Lewiston to reduce the speed limit on certain public roadways.
Do we have a motion? We have a motion to approve, and by Senator Robach, second by Senator Benjamin. Senator Skoufis.
I think this is maybe the second or third type of this bill that we've brought up this year. And I'm unfamiliar with this process. So I thought that if a town wanted to adjust a speed limit on a road in their jurisdiction or a village, they have to petition DOT, and then they do some sort of traffic study, then DOT comes back and adjusts it after there's a study. Before this year, I'd never seen legislation to sort of preempt that process. So can you describe why we're not deferring to the experts at DOT to do a traffic study and what they normally do before making adjustments to these speed limits?
Sure. So a lot of the time these bills do actually go through local governments, but there are some that have been passed and chaptered in previous years. A lot of the time, which I think you probably hear about it more a little farther upstate, but there are a lot of occasions where municipalities have petitioned DOT for years to try and get changes, and they have a lot of trouble doing that. And so it sort of gets to this point where you end up with a bill to try and do
it. I'm not certain, but I think even if DOT says it, I actually think we have to pass it.
I don't think so.
No. It depends on where.
Because I thought that there's certain roads where like the speed limit is always supposed to be like 30 or 35, and when you change it, even from an enforcement standpoint, you have to change the law, the markings, and let people know. And the only reason why I said that, because we've had that in towns in Monroe County before, and we just had to do a bill, and that was like 10 years ago. So I don't know what it is, but I think something else has to go on.
Sure. So, and yes, actually, if it is below 30, so other than in a school zone, and so they actually do want to lower it to 25. So that, normally there is statutory authorization on that front as well. So
thank you for
that reminder.
Thank you.
All right. We do have a home rule on this bill, and so we have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None? Motion carries. Next bill.
Senate Bill 1015 by Senator Comrie. This bill will be referred to Finance, an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to the special powers of the authority.
This is the Freedom Ticket Bill by Senator Comrie, a priority bill for Senator Comrie. Do we have any questions? Motion on the bill?
Motion.
We have a motion to approve by Senator Benjamin.
Second.
And a second by Senator Skoufis. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. We'll refer to Finance. Next bill.
Senate 1710 by Senator Carlucci. This bill will go to Codes, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law in relation to including prior convictions of operation of a vessel while under the influence of alcohol or drugs as prior convictions of driving while intoxicated.
Do we have a motion on this bill? We have a motion from Senator Kaplan, second by Senator Persaud. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. That'll be referred to Codes. Next bill.
Senate Bill 2687 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law in relation to creating a pilot program for the field testing of mobile telephones or portable electronic devices by local police departments in Westchester County, and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof, and this will go to Finance.
Do we have a motion on this bill? Motion by Senator Benjamin. Do we have a second?
Second.
By Senator
Kaplan.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
I'm AW.
Without Rec.
And
I'm without Rec as well. Sorry.
We have without Rec Senator Skoufis, Senator Persaud, Senator Kaminsky, Senator Jacobs. Motion is carried, and that bill also will be referred to Finance. Next bill.
Senate 2773 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to requiring Metropolitan Transportation Authority and the New York City Transit Authority to implement certain standards pertaining to applying and removing coatings from bridges, trestles, elevated subway, and railway tracks and stations.
Do we have any questions on this bill? Any motion?
My concern is, why is it just removing the coatings and not some other stuff?
So this is using...
I feel like this is halfway done, like there should be another legislation that could go a little bit further if there's like other stuff that...
So this actually, I think the title here is maybe a little misleading. It actually applies to painting, to maintaining, and to removing the coatings. One of the issues both on highways and also on different elevated bridges and subway lines and commuter rail lines is that there's a lead paint from years ago, and especially with elevated lines, it actually will fall down. And so so the intent here is to provide for safely removing, safely repainting, and then also maintaining the actual assets. So it's three different international standards that are in the bill.
Okay. But it's just dealing with paint, not anything else.
Right, yeah.
Does that answer questions?
Yes.
Okay, great. Do we have a motion on the bill? No. We have a motion by Senator Prasad, second by Senator Benjamin. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Without rec? None. Motion carries. Next bill.
Senate Bill 3055 by Senator Gorin, an act to amend the navigation law in relation to revoking a person's driver's license following the conviction of operating a vessel while under the influence of alcohol or drugs.
We have a motion on this bill. Senator Kaplan, Senator Benjamin, second. Any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Without rec.
Senator Galvin in the negative. Anybody else in the negative? Without rec, Senator Skoufis. Anybody else? With that, motion carries. Next bill.
Senate Bill 3185 by Senator Kennedy. This bill will be referred to Finance. An act to amend the transportation law in relation to establishing the Hyperloop and High-Speed Rail Commission.
We have any questions on the bill? We have a motion by Senator Jacobs. Do we have a second? By Senator Skoufis. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Without rec.
Without rec, Senator Galvin. Anybody else? Motion carries, and this bill will be referred to Finance. Next bill.
Senate Bill 3399 by Senator Brooks, an act to amend the navigation law in relation to enacting Brianna's Law.
Now, this is a very important bill. I want to recognize that this bill is about boater safety and ensuring that individuals that are behind the controls of a vessel on the water have the proper education and certificate to operate that vessel. This is named after a young woman who passed after an accident, Brianna Linek. We are joined this morning by Brianna's mother, Gina. Gina, thank you for joining us, and we hope that the passage of this bill will give you and your family comfort in knowing that Brianna is still with us and her legacy will live on and hopefully make our communities safer.
Thank you so much.
Any questions on this bill? We have a motion by Senator Kaplan, second by Senator Benjamin. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Without rec? None. The motion carries, and I want to thank Senator Brooks for his advocacy on this extremely important measure. Thank you again, Gina, for joining us here this morning. Next bill.
Senate Bill 3466 by Senator Griffo. This bill will be referred to Finance, an act to amend the highway law in relation to authorizing the town of Deerfield in Oneida County to transfer jurisdiction of a road to the state.
We have a motion by Senator Robach, second by Senator Benjamin.
Can I just ask, has DOT
questions?
Are they in support of this transfer? Sorry. Is DOT in support of this transfer? Do we have any word from them?
So my understanding is that DOT does not project, well, the DOT is already maintaining the road, yeah. So this is in some ways really just codifying what our current practice is.
Okay.
All set? We have a motion and a second. Any other questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None without rec? None. Motion carries. So that bill, again, will be referred to finance. Next bill.
Senate Bill 3837 by Senator Gunardis, an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to membership on the board of the Metropolitan Transportation Authority.
Do we have any questions on this bill? We have a motion by Senator Kaplan, second by Senator Persaud. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. And without rec? None. Motion carries. Next bill.
Senate Bill 4334 by Senator Metzger, an act to amend the highway law in relation to designated portion of the state highway system in Ulster County as the Gary Petro Paiolo Memorial Highway.
We have a motion on this bill by Senator Robach. We have a second. And Senator Persaud. Any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Without rec? None. Motion carries. Next bill.
Senate Bill 4890 by Senator Parker. This bill will be referred to finance. An act to amend the public authorities law in relation to requiring New York City Transit Authority to have at least one conductor on board.
Do we have a motion on this bill? A motion by Senator Persaud and a second by Senator Benjamin. All in favor?
May I first ask?
Yeah. I'm sorry.
I waited that time.
You did wait. I messed up. My apologies. Senator Skoufis.
Okay. I'm just trying to, I'd love to hear some rationale for this bill, you know, at a time when the MTA is I think, in good faith trying to find savings. My understanding is they have identified potentially some new technology that doesn't require each subway set of cars to have two employees on them. Does this handcuff their ability to save some money? What's the point of this bill?
Yeah, so this a lot of the different transit workers themselves have supported legislation. There's a few different versions of bills to oppose one person train operation and ensure that you have both that engineer on board and the conductor. The argument, like from the A-Train derailment back in 2017, was that if you didn't have that second employee on board, it would really be chaos. Similar sort of rationale with respect to, like, you know, different sorts of emergency situations. You know, if there was a terrorist attack or something, the idea is that having qualified employees around and on the trains can help help make situations safer and you know, safely evacuate and guide strap hangers.
What is the potential savings if they moved to one person trains?
I don't think the MTA has come out and published a figure.
I have to imagine it's got to be hundreds of millions, if not billions of dollars.
I don't know. I can't speak to that.
Okay. You know, I'm with respect, Mr. Chairman, I'm personally uncomfortable sort of preempting the MTA board's at least ability to consider moving in this direction. I'll be a no on this.
Fair. Any other questions? So we have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Senator Skoufis. Without rec? Without rec, Senator Jacobs. Motion carries. We're referring that to finance.
And last
bill, yep.
Senate Bill 4976 by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law in relation to authorizing the issuance of distinctive license plates for family members of paid professional firefighters who died in the line of duty.
On behalf of Senator Skoufis, who are these people?
questions. Senator Robach, questions. Yes, sir. Senator Jacobs.
Why is it just paid professional? Why wouldn't you have a volunteer or they're already?
I mean, this is based on the request we got from, we received from the association. So.
Could we amend it to have volunteer firefighters too?
Certainly.
And there is a separate license plate for volunteer firefighters as well.
Who have died in?
I believe it would. There are volunteers as well that have license plate in that who have been passed away in that. But that's something we can check on and amend if it's not the case.
I think that's right.
Okay. Well, if not, that'd be great if we could amend it to both.
Of course. Any other questions? We have a motion. Senator Robach, second. Senator Benjamin, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Without rec, none. Motion carries.
Sorry.
Thank you, everybody. That will call this meeting.
I wanted to change.